call them forcers, Gordon. I sell women's shoes.
And the Stallion.
Stallion, baby!
I am not what you would call a handsome man.
I'll kick you in the nuts and you'll smile at me and like it.
All night long!
Welcome back to another edition of the All Night Long Wrestling Podcast. We are your hosts. He is the Stallion. I am the Enforcer. And right off the bat...
No, don't do it.
Oh, God. Breaking news. Be prepared, everybody. We took the week off last week. That's breaking, right?
Is it?
Let me tell you something.
Yeah, all those people that follow our Twitter and Facebook and
I'll get
subscribe
there.
To the podcast and everything on iTunes and everything like that.
Yeah.
I know I was getting a lot of messages asking what happened last week, so.
You know, I feel like I've had a ton of energy going into the show.
Sorry, go ahead.
We took the week off last week, not through anybody's fault, but inept, overprivileged. Help me here.
Mean Street Posse? Is that where we're going with
Nope,
this?
Nope. I'm going with people that work for you that are unreliable and suck. Because 2 weeks ago we were talking about how the Stallion and I were going to be going to the Impact show in St. James, New York. I was very excited for that. Unfortunately... that did not happen for me, at least. I was glad Joe got to go with Buddy Charlie, and that was great. I'm glad they had a good time. I was at work because you're very popular when everybody needs something from you. But God forbid you need a favor. Not even a favor. You just ask somebody to do their job, and they can't do it. So I was slinging vitamins all day while you're over there hanging out with Eli Drake. You're hanging out with Eli Drake.
Dummy, yeah.
Yeah, actually, can I get that one more time?
Dummy, yeah.
Good. I was reaching for the same thing. Yeah, that was unfortunate, and it's 4 days later, and I'm still fuming, because not only did I not get to go, not only did I find out the night before / morning of, but I also wasted a $70 ticket. Really puts things in perspective, huh, buddy?
Yep.
Everything's fun. I know you, the good news is you had a really easy week at work.
Yeah, no problems.
Yeah, no, everything's good. I think the better news is that Raw and SmackDown have been off the charts lately.
They have,
really some
viewership is skyrocketing, is my understanding.
Actually, I just saw that SmackDown hit like a 6-week high this week.
Yeah.
So that's good. Jinder Mahal is really...
They put Jinder in the main event. That's the key.
Oh, really? Because I feel like he almost never wrestles.
Special attraction.
Yeah,
that's how it works.
Real, real special. So what are we going to be talking about this week on the All Long Wrestling Podcast? This is what we call a tweener week. There's really not much to talk about in terms of WWE. We'll talk about a little Raw, a little SmackDown. We're going to talk about NXT. And then I also want to talk some G1 Climax 2017. Because as of writing this, as of recording this,
we have one of those court stenographers.
Stenographer,
here.
Yeah.
Yeah, they're just recording everything that we say down into like one of those little pieces of paper that looks like it's from the cash register. So we're going to have that.
What do they call that? A typewriter.
Yeah, it sounds right.
Yeah, that sounds right.
Stenographer.
Stenographer.
Stenog.
So, where the hell is it going with this? I don't know. We're going to talk about some stuff. We're going to have a special guest on our show next week. I'm going to tease it now. A big show next week. A big show planned for the All Night Long Wrestling Podcast. I'm going to have the one and only Mr. Rogers on the show. Wait a second. That's not right. Is he?
I think he's no longer with us. I'm pretty sure.
He passed away?
I believe so.
Son of a bitch.
You want to Google that?
Who have I been tweeting?
I don't know. You should probably... I would not. If somebody's posing as Mr. Rogers, I don't think that... he passed away in 2003. So I'm not sure if Twitter... There was Twitter in 2003, actually. So
who do you...
Maybe he has an account from the beyond.
I do listen to a lot of paranormal podcasts. Maybe... Oh, no. That's so it's not Mr. Son of a...
Well, it's not, Mr. Rogers, Mr. Rogers' Neighborhood.
You think it's one of those porn bots? Like, Laylel Sex... Pat 9?
I mean, anything's possible. I don't know. I would. I mean, maybe there's like a Twitter, you know, support email
that
you
can reach out to. Okay, I'll. Okay.
Does it have the blue check mark on his account when you're?
No, we don't even have the blue check mark on anyone.
That's different. That's a different story altogether. Really,
we're not verified.
No, God, we don't know much of anything right now.
No, we're just two vessels living life in this cycle. Well, this got dark, huh? Let's get back on track.
Buddy. Sure.
Let's get back. So as of us recording this right now, speaking of the G1, I'm going to touch on that real quick. We'll start there. There are two matches tomorrow morning. Oh, no, actually, Friday and Saturday. So they have 2 days off. Friday is going to be Tanahashi versus Naito, I believe, for the Block A finals. Yes, yeah, it's Tanahashi versus Naito, I'm pretty sure. Is that right?
I have to look it up. For some reason, I thought Okada Omega was that day, but I don't know which day.
So then, Okada Omega is the 12th. So, yeah, so I'm sorry, you're right. Okada Omega is going to be the 12th.
That's Saturday, then.
So that's going to be Saturday. And then whoever wins that is going to be the winner of the Block B. The winner of Block A is going to be determined when Naito takes on Tanahashi. I think it's been a very, very strong G1 climax so far. There have been a lot of, you know, you have guys like a Yuji Nagata. Yuji Nagata's been in New Japan since the NWO days, and he went 0, and I think he might have actually won one, but he's 49 years old, and the man's been, you know, putting on some really good matches. There are a couple of surprises. Elgin got eliminated very early, Michael Elgin did, but I think he's had a phenomenal run of matches, and though he got eliminated early, he's still, you know, they're showing a lot of fighting spirit, so he's still winning matches now. They're a little bit late. He's actually the only, he was the first person to get the win over Kenny Omega. Omega is currently 6-2. His only losses have come to Michael Elgin, and do you know who the other one was?
Who, Omega's losses? Yeah. It was the Juice Robinson.
Yeah, Juice Robinson. It was a really good match. It was a roll-up finish. I love... I'm a big fan for how they did not have Omega and Okada go undefeated until the end. I like how they showed some chinks in the armor. And I think, let's see. So, Tanahashi...
Do you have any... Let me ask you this. I think that before...
Oh, wait, I'm sorry. I was right. It was Tanahashi and Naito. So really quick, August 11th, the winner of the Tanahashi Naito is going to take on the winner of Okada and Omega. So I was a little upset because I thought it was going to be Kota Ibushi. I thought we were going to see an Ibushi-Omega final. That's not the case. Ibushi's had a really good tournament. He's been strong. But Tanahashi, he lost early to Zack Sabre Jr. And Naito's... Yeah, I think Naito's got to win. Naito's got to beat the ace. He's got to beat Tanahashi. And now the other thing is, Kenny Omega is 6-2. Okada is 6-1-1. Okada's lone loss has come to Evil in a fantastic match, and he had a draw last night with Minoru Suzuki, which I disagree with, but it was what it was. So if Okada and Omega go to a 30-minute time limit draw, then Okada still wins the block. Okada doesn't have to, you know, Okada doesn't have to win an in. Omega does have to win an in. So it's going to be, I wouldn't hate seeing another Okada versus Tanahashi match, but I think the money should be on Naito, and I think the money's going to be on Omega.
Do you feel that this is too predictable? That the final, after all this, the final four guys are probably the final four guys that everybody thought it would come down to in the end?
Yes, I do. Absolutely. I think the road to get there has been very interesting, but as far as the final four, you know, there were some teases, but I feel like a lot of the stronger guys got eliminated early. I mean, I would have liked to see Ibushi in it. I really would have. I would have also liked to see a stronger showing from Goto. He's another guy I really think deserved it, and Elgin would have been a really cool addition to the final four. But I think the way that New Japan books it, so Omega lost to Juice. Omega is the U.S. Heavyweight Champion, so that can set up a Kenny Omega versus Juice match. Okada lost to Evil, that could set up an Okada versus Evil match later on for the title. So I like the way they got there, but I do feel that it was far too predictable, yes. The other thing I think is going to be interesting is the 30-minute time limit on the Okada versus Omega match. These guys have never wrestled less than 30 minutes. Their first match was 47 minutes. The second match was a 60-minute time limit draw. I think a lot of people are anticipating a draw out of this match. I think it would make sense to have Kenny Omega win it. So, excuse me, that way it's 1-1-1, and then winner take all at Wrestle Kingdom. I don't know if that's going to happen. I would love to see Naito get the briefcase. I think the guy has done more than enough to be the champion, to deserve, I should say. He brought, 3 years ago, Naito was toiling around in obscurity, and now he's the biggest heel. Well, he's kind of like a heel face. Everybody loves him. And, you know, he's just another guy who's putting on consistently good matches in this tournament with people that are just not really up to his level. And I think that's a mark of a really good champion, somebody that could definitely carry the company. God knows the LIJ merch sales are almost up there with the Bullet Club, so I don't think they would have an issue putting the title on him. They had it on before. They just didn't give him a long enough run. So giving the briefcase to Naito to cash in would be... would
they
be
actually have a briefcase for this?
Yeah. It's a briefcase.
What's in the briefcase?
The contract.
They have a contract with a briefcase?
Yeah.
Sounds familiar.
Not necessarily. I mean, it's... Why are we coming out with the negativity?
I'm just saying. I didn't know that they actually had it. That's why I was asking.
Yeah, they do have a briefcase.
So I just didn't know that they were infringing on gimmicks.
I'm going to look it up. I'm gonna see who had the briefcase.
Yeah, first. Give me a gif of that. A gif.
Give you
a... I want peanut butter and jelly.
Anyway, as I look this up, what are your thoughts on the end of the tournament?
I haven't seen every match, obviously, because it's 18, 19 nights, which is longer than Hanukkah, quite frankly. I don't understand why.
It is actually longer than Hanukkah, but this contributes to a lot of my weight loss because I've been watching G1 matches while I've been doing the stairs at the gym.
I haven't seen all of them matches, but I just, I think the thing was... Yeah, I think when the tournament started, now I pay attention to New Japan. I don't watch every single show because there's just not enough time in the day to do that. But I think just going into it, you're like, all right, if you look at the blocks, and you're like, all right, it'll probably be Naito and Tanahashi in one and Omega and Okada in the other. And then like 3 weeks later, however long it is, that's what we wound up with. So I'm sure there's plenty of good matches mixed in there and different things happening. But we're right down to the same thing we thought would happen, or that everybody probably thought would happen in the beginning. It would have been nice if maybe one of those guys was not involved here. I mean, you could have probably taken any one of them out. And had it be fine, like Tanahashi's nursing a bicep injury. He's the Intercontinental Champion there now. But it said he's going to fight Naito again for the 800th time. And then Okada and Omega fought a couple times already. I would assume the smart money would be that Omega will win this time because he hasn't beaten him yet, which is fine. I don't think there's any... If he ends up winning this again this year, that just seems... I don't know. I don't know why. To do the whole thing and have it be exactly what it was before... just seems like almost like it's kind of a... You could have gotten there another way and had somebody else win it. So I'm hoping that's not what happens.
You have all four of these guys right now. Who's not going to win in your mind?
I don't think Tanahashi's going to win. I would be surprised, I guess, if he...
Agreed.
If he won.
Yep, I agree with that.
I'd say he's probably the third. And I guess I would also be surprised if Okada won, because then if he wins, then nobody gets the shot at Wrestle Kingdom. Or actually, it's not based off of this, right?
Yeah, not based upon this. If Okada wins, then pretty much he chooses... who he wants to face. So yeah. I think the more I think about it, because I don't know that... I think maybe once the champion has won, I'd have to look that up. But I thinking about it, that would be an interesting wrinkle. And then you guys... I guess you have kind of whoever he deems, worthy of it. That would be interesting. It'd be something different.
I mean, to me, it should be Naito. Because if you look at the four guys that can win, three of them have titles right now. So it's like... To me, it would make sense for Naito to be the guy that wins because he doesn't have a title. I don't know if there'll be other matches, obviously, between now and Wrestle Kingdom, which is in January. But I would think it would be him. I don't think giving it to Tanahashi would... I mean, he's been in the main event so many times. He's the Intercontinental Champion. He's banged up. I wouldn't give it to him. Omega won it.